NerdDice.
Welcome to the Stateless Codecast. This is episode number 79 in our series, Create a RubyGem, NerdDice. So we've got an epic on use of convenience methods that's been using Ruby, overriding Ruby's method missing to allow for dynamic creation of methods. We are now essentially feature complete on this epic, but there are some opportunities to do some refactoring that we've been delaying until a bit later. So you can see here the overall size of this module is pretty big. It's got some repeated code. It's got some repeated regular expression literals that we want to potentially move into constants. So we'll go with that first. So let's actually make that our first part of this. So all right, so the first thing I'm going to try is seeing if I can take this and call it dis. Should be part of this. Let's try it the one place. Let's see if I can interpolate that and keep stuff from breaking. Still works. Excellent. So that will save us some space here. So in all those cases, the specs. And now we'll do the same thing with working. Let's make sure RuboCop doesn't get upset by that. Extract this. All right. Let's see. Freeze it. But it looks like they're all auto-correctable, so we'll see before we go any further how RuboCop wants it done. Alright, so dot freeze. Yeah, I think just dot freeze was what it was upset about. Occurs in a lot of places. Call that mod. Let me just see all the places where that particular pattern exists. Yeah, so passing, and now let's go in and find that example everywhere else. The idea, I'll pause. Alright, so I've got that replaced everywhere. Oh, I broke some stuff. Unmatched close parentheses. In line 107. Oh, 'cause it's that whole expression. Yeah. I just need to get rid of all those. I'll clean that up. Pause. Let's see if I unbroke everything now. I did. RuboCop is not taking me to the slammer, which is good. this situation, I think... the way that all of these work I think I can just do roll with the mod there, get rid of these four methods, and then in the define role, define total, which I can probably get rid of those two methods, call like we did with advantage and disadvantage, where we set the modifier in the define method block, and then, yeah, I think that's gonna, so. Question mark. Define role. Actually, we'll leave these alone. We'll move these up with the hope that I can get rid of all of that. Get things working there. So total MD and N. So instead of making this a plus, we'll make it a star. And then at the end there, we'll make these modifier. And then I think we can, so the number of dice, we can just make that default one if it doesn't match. So get rid of those. And then our plus and minus don't need separate methods because we just did it without separate methods in that situation. So let's try it with roll here. So in our situation here, method name, go down, and already doing it. So it matches. So yeah, we can just do that. It'll be one if it's one, and then add these two modifier items. Do the same thing for total. Thank you. Let's see what that gives us. We've got four failures. I bet it's because it's calling it with one instead of, yep, 21, 81, 21. But you know what? We can change that. We don't care whether that optional argument is sent in, so so that gets us down to significantly fewer methods that we're calling. So this is no longer used. Let's just, I think we can actually get rid of those. Get rid of all the methods that they were calling. Highest n. We can probably combine those, but let's not get ahead of ourselves. So the plus and minus are gone. The total plus and minus are gone. Still working. Let's see if we can get rid of that module length metric. Too many lines, 192. So we're still, we'll get that back, get that back. See what RuboCop is fussing about right now. 104, 123, 124. Lowest. Alright, so take a look at what we've, oh, they're all autocorrectable, so let's not. And so you may have thought, as especially if you've watched through all these videos, that the specs here are overkill. But when you're going in, especially in a metaprogramming instance here, it's good to have more than you need rather than less than you need. Once we get all of this stuff hammered out, we can maybe look at refactoring some of the specs into shared examples or whatnot. But having all of those different scenarios for our different items there, usually you want to not repeat yourself, but in this case, when you're dealing with metaprogramming, it's not too bad of a of an issue. So let's see if we can drill down and eliminate any more of these. So highest, lowest. Still some fat to trim here. Total DNN isn't even being called anymore, I don't think. Some redundancy here that we can just refactor out as well. One way to, let's get this out, see how bad RuboCop thinks it is. So 22 out of 10, 11 out of 7. We can just break this so we've got the roll match and the total match. So we can say def that. total. Just do break anything? I did not. Too many lines on each of those. If I can just bring the then back and getting here, 112. Yeah, I think I can. That's what we need. All right, let's see if we can do the same thing with roll. No offenses down to this highest and highest N. Sides is defaulting to 2. What are we? Get sides from method name. That get sides from method name. So maybe I can same thing for, actually it's not the right method that I'm doing that there. DNN highest, this is where we're defaulting to 2. So here is where we want. Undefined method. So maybe I just need to make that D a star instead of a plus. So that broke too many places. I think I'm going to just undo that. So I've got that one more disabled. Define highest and define lowest. Lowest and total. What I can just maybe default lowest n version here. Number of dice method name, and then pass 2 there. Yeah, I think that'll work. So let me try that on all of the items there. Pause and do it. So 148, we're getting close in terms of being able to get this down. So we've got the, I think the one thing that we can do, so highest and lowest have a lot of repeated code between them. So I think that's the next thing to attack, but we're getting on in terms of our length of things here. Let me take a look at the git status. So I will So I think we're going to stop and commit here, but I want to dig down and get this even leaner. But we've made a lot of progress so far, so I think I'll commit and push what we've got, but leave the item in progress. So I will specs are just those changes that we noted there. I'll pause and write my commit message. So I've got my message. Say it, sign it. Push to the remote. Take a look at the diff here. So see the number of lines of code slashed here is very significant and always something to be on the watch for. So we went from 346 lines to 235 lines, and there's still more that we can do. So always want to keep in mind that every line of code that you write is a liability, not an asset. So if you can do the same function with fewer lines of code and it doesn't look terrible, then you want to be able to refactor those things out and do that. I think this commit provides a much more elegant implementation of the method missing features, and then we'll continue attacking. I think we can get this highest and lowest into refactored out. There's still a lot of repeating code between those, so that's what we'll work on in the next video. The workflow is green, so we'll take it from there.
Thanks for watching this Stateless Codecast. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and spread the word. You can follow us on social media at Stateless Code. Until next time, keep coding, and don't aggress against peaceful people or vote for others to do so on your behalf.